the occasion of the 72nd Republic Day, I extend my greetings to the people of Andhra Pradesh and I salute the founding fathers of our nation who have struggled to make India free, and the architect of our constitution which has laid down the guiding principle for us to progress with dignity and decorum. It is prudent here to recall what Prime Minister Narendra Modi had recently said, quoting legendary Telugu playwright and reformist Gurujada Appa Rao by saying, Desamante Mati Kuadoi, Desamante Manu Suloya. Very aptly, the preamble of our constitution begins with, we people. More than 7 decades ago, on this day, our constitution has come into effect, which has placed on our shoulders the responsibility to adhere to justice, liberty, equality, and fraternity, which are the main tenets of democracy. The darkness, nobody has tested it. It's looking dark. The government has clear-cut agenda of all-round development of the state. It laid emphasis on education, medical and health, agriculture and welfare. The government has launched numerous schemes to benefit all the sections of the people. The beneficiaries are selected in a transparent manner without any discrimination of caste, creed, religion, or political affiliation, and the schemes are implemented in 100% saturation mode. Before listing our the details of the welfare schemes, the acumen with which our government had handled the COVID pandemic merits praise. We have passed through testing times. With the outbreak of COVID pandemic, and my government had effectively handled the situation, taking measures which have won accolades from across the country. With vaccination rolling out in days back, run has been smooth and government has put in place the necessary infrastructure. Which includes storage and movement mechanism of the vaccines. We have to respect all faiths, and that is what our tradition has been. The recent distractions from the guiding principle laid down in the preamble of our constitution are very distressing. The government is very firm in safeguarding the social fabric which is spun by the colorful yarn of various faiths that reflects unity in diversity. While the government believes this principle in letter and spirit, some vested interests have been trying to whip up passions by instigating and restoring to unsavory incidents which are crude, meaningless, and are blessed with ulterior motives. Desecration, vandalism, arson, and all sorts of acts of insanity have no place in our society, and those responsible for the aberrations will be dealt with firmly by all means to restore peace and harmony in the state, which has been making rapid strides in the term of welfare and development. Housing for all, Navaratnalu. We established Vaikuntha Ekadasi and Christmas on December 25 with the government taking up the huge task of distributing nearly 31 lakh house sites in the poor and also begin the construction of houses. Such a program was never held in the country earlier. There are some hurdles for implementation of welfare schemes. However, government went ahead and distributed the house sites pattas in all litigation free areas. It was not construction of houses but a building of habitations with the 30.75 lakh beneficiaries, of which 28.30 lakh houses are coming up in 17,000 Vaisar Jagannanna layouts. In the first phase, construction of 15.60 lakh houses has commenced with a cost of 28,084 crores, and the remaining 12.70 lakh houses will be taken up soon. The government has acquired 68,361 acres of land worth rupees 23,535 crores, and the beneficiary would be given the choice either to build houses on their own, seek help for material components, or to delegate the work to the government in toto. Never before was such a massive exercise taken up by any government with clear markings, title deeds registered in the name of the woman of the household. TIDCO houses. The government has delivered sale agreements pertaining to 2.62 lakh TIDCO houses worth rupees 21,345 crores to eligible women beneficiaries in urban areas, of which 1,43,600 TIDCO houses of 370 are handed over to for just rupees 1. The transparency of the government is very much seen by one and all with direct benefit transfer of amount to the beneficiaries, giving scope for no scope for pilferage of and corruption. Not long ago, people in the public life were worried as only 15 paisa of the rupees was reaching the intended sections. The answer has come in the form of a DBT by the government, which has crediting amount to beneficiaries directly with the click of a button in the pool grayer of media and beneficiaries arising their views and happiness. On the 1st of every month, social security pensions are being dispersed at the doorstep to the old and disabled, putting an end to their ordeal of standing in long queues and foregoing the day's wage and complying with the temperamental functioning of the gadgets of the dispersing officers. Past examples have shown us that concentration of development at a singular place would lead to unrest and regional imbalances. The government is of the firm view that decentralization of development with Visakhapatnam as the executive capital, Amaravati being legislative capital, and Kurnool as the judicial capital would assure the balanced development of the region. Agriculture sector. The economy of our state is predominantly agrarian, and government is leaving no stone unturned to encourage agriculture and its allied fields, and has launched several pro-farmer schemes in the sector. YSR Ritu Bharosa. Under YSR Ritu Bharosa, which has completed two rounds, ₹13,500 is paid directly into the farmers' bank accounts in three installments for a period of 5 years. Though it was promised only ₹12,500 for 4 years, but was enlarged for the farmers' welfare. The government has already paid ₹13,101 crore as Raitu Bharosa assistance, benefiting 51.59 lakh farmers, and ours is the only government to extend the benefit to the tenured farmers assigned lands on ROR and pattas as well. YSR Ritu Bharosa Kendra, put some light. Bharosa Kendra, adjacent to village secretaries, 10,641 YSR Ritu Bharosa Kendras have been established to clear to the needs of our farmers. From seed to sale of the agricultural producers, RVK will be supply quality certified seeds, fertilizers and pesticides, among others. Procurement agriculture producers. The government has established a price stabilization fund of ₹3,000 crore to do market investment in the agriculture and horticulture produce. State marketing department has procured 14.96 lakh MTS of agriculture commodity worth ₹5,460 crores, which is a record in Andhra Pradesh history. Out of this, more than ₹2,500 crore was procured during lockdown period, which proves the government's commitment towards farmers. Put some light. Like never before, the government is handling over compensation for crop loss suffered in a season before the end of that particular season itself. Government has so far paid ₹1,055.20 crore on the input subsidy covering 13.69 lakh farmers and 18.57 lakh acres of land, including the pending compensation. YSR Sunabhadi. Under YSR Sunabhadi Panta Runalu, the government has spent ₹2,089 crores so far, benefiting 14.26 lakh farmers. We can proudly say that we have cleared previous dues of Sunabhadi Panta Ranalu amounting to ₹904 crores, covering 51.24 lakh farmers. Pre-power to agriculture sector. The government has spent ₹17,430 crores towards pre-power subsidy to farmers sector, ₹700 crores for new feeders to supply 9 hours uninterrupted pre-quality power during daytime. OSR pre-crop insurance. After formation of this government, an amount of ₹1,960 crores settled towards crop insurance claims, benefiting 15.67 lakh farmers, was distributed. The largest number of farmers, 49.81 lakh farmers and 45.96 lakh hectares have been brought under insurance cover in 2019-2020 by implementing OSR pre-crop insurance. The premium on behalf of farmers was paid by state government itself. OSR Jalkala, fulfilling the promise made to farmers, the government will drill 2 lakh bore well and provide motors free to cost under this scheme across the state in 4 years, including an expenditure of around ₹4,000 crores, thereby providing irrigation facility to an additional 5 lakh acres of agricultural land. Andhra Pradesh Amulpala Veluva, fulfilling another promise, the government has taken up a major initiative to ensure additional income of at least ₹5 to 7 per litre milk to each and every dairy farmer. For this, an MOU has been signed with Amul to help dairy farmers. This will do away with the middleman in milk procurement, which will now be done through women cooperative societies, and ensure payment in trade days to milk procurers. Establishment of automated milk collection centers, but milk cooling units and processing units in 9,899 villages across the state is in progress. Jagan Anna Jiva Karanth, aiming to provide stable income and better livelihood to women farmers, my government has started distributing of 2,49,151 sheep goat units across the state with an expenditure of ₹1,869 crores. Education sector. The syntax of education was given a new meaning by promoting government schools, revamping them and dusting out of dilapidated look and going for a total makeover and providing facilities like running water, toilets, furniture, fixtures, kitchen set, staff and other amenities. No wonder there has been a steady flow of new students from other schools to government schools. Jagan Anna Amabodhi. Under Jagan Anna Amabodhi, the government deposits ₹15,000 per annum in the bank accounts of mothers for sending her children to school, as the state believes that no mother should stop sending her children to school due to poverty. The government deposited the amount for the second year in a row in January. Jaganana Vidya Kanuka. Jaganana Vidya Kanuka kits are provided to children for students of class 1 to 10, comprising 3 pair of uniform, text and notebooks, bags, shoes and 3 pairs of socks. As soon as the school reopens, the government has spent ₹648 crores so far to benefit 42 lakhs 34,322 students. In order to ensure qualitative, tasty and nutritious midday meal is served to the children, the revamped midday meal program has been launched in the name of Jagannana Guru Mudda since 21st January 2020. Another innovative and most useful practical program of the government is the introduction of English medium from class 1 to class 6. English medium enables our poor children to compete globally and nationally with children from affluent families. Medical and health sectors. Arogya Mahabhagyam, health is wealth. YSR Arogya Asara. Under YSR Arogya Asara, financial assistance of rupees 225 per day and up to rupees 5,000 per month with the paid during the post-operative reoccupation period for patients, and the state has so far paid rupees 2,000 crores covering 3.7 lakh beneficiaries. YSR Kanti Velugu, the government has spent rupees 53.85 crores under YSR Kanti Velugu covering 67.69 lakh students. In the first and second phases, screening was conducted in 60,401 schools. The third phase is in progress. Pre-operations and pre-specialists will be given to the needy under this program. A total of rupees 560 crores will be spent on the scheme in six phases. Nadu Nedu. Under Nadu Nedu, the government hospitals are being upgraded to the national standards. In addition to the existing 11 teaching hospitals, 16 more, along with the nursing colleges with 8,000 crores will come up, three new cancer hospitals and kidney specialist hospitals will be established soon. Six multi-special hospitals are to be set up in ITDs. As part of this program, 1,147 PSCs, 28 area hospitals, 14 district hospitals and 191 community health centers are being modernized. The government is taking up the program with a cost of rupees 16,300 crores. True character, grit and determination of the individual or institution is revealed during the times of adversity. COVID pandemic has challenge to the entire humanity, and I can proudly say my government has successfully risen up to the challenge and countered the menace. A few measures that were taken in this regard are